Welcome back to Mr. Speller's Math Tutorials. Today's task is to find the properties of a parallelogram. All right, let's go ahead and get started. Here we have a parallelogram. We know that the opposite sides here are parallel, so let's place in some arrows to show that. We know that the top and bottom are also parallel, so let's place in the double arrows to show that. We also know that the length of the top is congruent to the length of the bottom, so single tally marks. We know the length of the left-hand side is congruent to the length of the right-hand side. We're going to use double tally marks. We know that opposite angles are congruent, so this angle here is congruent to this angle. Matter of fact, let's put in the, or let's label this parallelogram. Let's call this A, B, C, and D. So angle D is congruent to angle B. We know that angle A is also congruent to angle C. Let's go ahead and draw in some diagonals. So this diagonal here from D to B and another diagonal from A to C. All right, these diagonals bisect each other. And what that means is that this length here, actually let's label this, let's call this X where they intersect. So that means this length here is congruent to this length here. And also, I know that, actually, let's make this three tally marks. So let's go to green this time and let's undo those. So we need three here, one, two, three, and we need three here, one, two, three. And this, where these two intersect, here, DX, one, two, three, four is congruent to XB, one, two, three, four. We know that angle A plus the measure of angle B is 180 degrees. And that goes around this parallelogram. So angle B plus angle C is also 180. Angle C plus D is 180. And angle D plus angle A is also 180. Again, all those are supplementary. All right, well, that sums up this tutorial. If you like it, please like it. And as always, thank you for watching.